don't know where we'll sound for some place I'd like to go.
Feed someone today, my brother, sister, niece, nephew, cousin, doesn't matter, grandfather maybe. Maybe I'll feed that old man in the park. Because it's raining and it's cold. And if you ain't got a place to go, you can stay on fire with me, cause I play in the fire. And if you don't think so, come and find me.
Oh, oh! Man, could've been worse than you would ever know.
This raps on the block, boy. It's got Papa Goite at the core, the roots, because that's what it is. The father's the roots. Then you got the emerald, the aqua I hand dug, the opal I hand polished, a diamond, and a Brandenburg amethyst. All on my heart right now, shining so hard. People don't even have a single clue who I am or what I do. Do you? Do I even know what I do? I don't know, but I do know that I got one of the sickest pendants on the block. And if you don't believe me, well, show me yours. Papa Goite, aqua from Mount Ontario, a hand dug, Venezuelan diamond right in the center. You got that Muzo emerald, hand polished Ethiopian opal, which I'm not partial to anymore. But you know, we grow, we learn from all the stones we connect with, we touch. Earth is a powerful place with a lot of different frequencies. If you're not experiencing them, then you're missing out on a lot. A whole lot. There's a whole friggin' library of knowledge and information and vibrations and amplifications and synergistic effects that come from stones. And if you dig them in bad manners, then bad things come to you. If you sell them under bad pretenses, bad things will come to you. I know this because I was there. And luckily, I got fired. Took me expressing myself to get fired from my job. And you know what? I am so thankful I did that, because now I am selling nothing but pure love. Love. Love is free and it's priceless. But in our society, for some reason, we have to put a dollar on something. And that is terrible. It boxes us in. It makes us have an ego. It makes us greedy. It makes us not understand why we are the way we are. And it's because money is a mask. It masks everything. And everyone thinks they can just buy something. Buy it. Just with money. And you can't. You can't do that with me. Some people can, but you gotta be pretty. You gotta be pretty knowledgeable. You gotta be a real cat. I love to trade. I love to paint with people as trading energy, as trading for payment. Payment comes in many different forms. Like I said, love is free and priceless. And if you don't believe me, go show someone some love. Listen to them. Be patient with them. Respect them. Show them that you care. It is very easy to do because it's free. But the second people take advantage of you, it becomes priceless because you realize what it's worth. It's worth everything in the world. This moment is all we have. So please share it with your brother, sister, mother, father, daughter, son, grandfather, grandmother, great, great grandfather, great, great grandmother. Anyone still kicking? I don't care if you don't even know them. Say hello. Say, how are you? I am here to express myself in this way because so many people don't know how to express themselves. It's taken me 31 years, people, to try to even learn how to express myself. And the one thing you learn is that communication is the one thing that is so clouded in misunderstanding and lost in translation. Our lives, our whole lives in school, we are taught to read and write, not to speak and listen. We are told to speak and listen. That is whack. That is why our society is whack, because people aren't aware of what they're saying and what they're listening to. They're only told very specific things. Speak. Listen. Well, teach me how to do it and maybe I'll do it better. You wonder what's wrong with the youth. You wonder what's going on in the world. Reading and writing is something you can do forever, over and over. And I'm not saying it's not important. I'm saying speaking and listening needs to have the forefront in our very early childhood education. It shows that we care. It shows that we respect. It shows that we're in the moment. It shows that we are conscious. Reading and writing is something you can think about and think about over and over and over again. And then finally, after you erase it so many times, you can write it that one time right. Well, speak it and listen to it the first time, one time, every time. Otherwise, you're just unconscious, floating around in this hurricane of turmoil and chaos. And if you don't stay focused and centered, you easily just have no idea what you're doing. No idea. So I'm asking you, like I ask myself every day, who am I? Well, I know my name, Isaac Dale Jones. That's at least the name given to me. I know I'm 31 years old. I know I was born in Nicholasville, Kentucky by midwives in a bathtub. I know a lot more about me than probably you do, but if you listen, you might learn something, because we learn together. I'm at the post office. You want to walk in the post office with me? I don't know if this video will last that long, but we can make it real, because that's all I have to show and share with the world. And it's weird. Talking to yourself or talking to people that you don't even see is kind of an illusion. For I want you to get off of your seat, out of your house. Don't watch me. Go do what I'm doing, but actually do it with intent to other people. Not afraid, not intimidated, not scared. Go live your life. Don't shroud it in mystery. Don't make it prose. This beautiful woman, Sheridan, I love you. She told me this word and it changed my life. Prose. Just look it up in the dictionary. Prose. P-R-O-S-E. See? I don't care what I look like because I've been crying laughing and enjoying this moment more than anyone, maybe. But I have to do what I have to do, no? No means see. See?